It was an ordinary day in Ukraine, where people were going to work and children were at school. Ukraine was a part of the Soviet Union at that time. No one knew that a massive catastrophe was going to happen that night, which is going to change the lives of hundreds of thousands of people forever. The Chernobyl nuclear power plant was located 14 kilometers away from the city of Chernobyl, where 14,000 people were living in 1986. Although the power plant was named Chernobyl, it was closer to the city of Pripyat with just 3 kilometers away. At the time of the accident, the population of Pripyat was around 49,000. Pripyat was a small city mostly populated by workers and their families, which was close to the Belarusian border and 93 kilometers from the capital Kiev. The construction of the Chernobyl nuclear power plant began in 1970. The first reactor unit of the power plant went into operation in 1977. Later, three more reactors were completed and started to operate. It was planned to turn the Chernobyl nuclear power plant into the world's largest, with 12 reactors of 1,000 megawatt each. Before the explosion, the power plant was operating with four reactors and two additional reactors were under construction. The fourth unit, where the accident occurred, had been in operation for 3 years. The operators of Chernobyl's fourth reactor were prepared to conduct an experiment. The experiment was to determine how long the turbines will power the main pumps in case the main power source is lost. The same experiment was carried out a year ago. The security systems were deliberately disabled so that they don't interfere with the reactor power. It was decided to conduct the experiment at a power level between 700 and 1000 megawatt. The reactor was on auto power mode. Suddenly, the power level dropped to 30 megawatt because the power setting was not set to 700. The operators tried to restore the power and eventually started the test at 200 megawatt, a power level much lower than initially planned. 30 seconds after the start of the test, the emergency stop signal came on the control panel. The operator pressed the reactor stop button and the control rods began to move down. A power increase occurred when the control rods entered the reactor. The power level reached 100 times the nominal value in just few seconds. This caused the pressure to rise as a result of excessive steam production. After the situation got out of control, two big explosions occurred a few seconds apart. The 1,000-ton cap that covered the reactor was blown up. The fuel rods melted as the temperature rose above 2,000 Celsius. The graphite covering the reactor caught fire, releasing enormous amounts of radiation into the environment. A red flame rose in the first explosion, and a blue flame in the second, and then a huge mushroom cloud covered the power plant. Shortly after the explosion, several people from Pripyat gathered on a railway bridge where they could see the power plant and the blue flame. It is argued that those people on that bridge that night died shortly after the accident due to high level of radiation. Today, this bridge is called the Bridge of Death because of this myth. Many firefighters from nearby areas were sent to the power plant to extinguish the burning reactor. This effort was terminated after 10 hours. In order to control the fire and trap the radiation, 2,400 tons of lead and 1,800 tons of sand were left from military helicopters onto the reactor for 9 days. In the final phase of the firefighting, the reactor core was cooled down using nitrogen. The fire and radioactive release could only be brought under control on 6 May, 10 days after the accident. The radiation spread to the environment was equal to 50 times of the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima in 1945. In June 1986, it was planned to install a cooling pool that will prevent the hot reactor fuel from drilling a hole in the foundation of the reactor, which may lead to the contamination of the soil and the groundwater. Coal miners were assigned to dig the tunnel. 400 coal miners dug a 168-meter-long tunnel under the reactor, which stopped a second potential disaster. The nuclear disaster caused the death of 31 people working at the power plant within few months because of acute radiation syndrome. However, the real devastating effects of the accident came out in the long term. According to some independent studies, the Chernobyl disaster caused the death of approximately 200,000 people. More than 70,000 people were permanently disabled. Due to the effects of the accident, 1.9 million people in Ukraine and 8.4 million people in Belarus, Russia, Ukraine, and European countries were exposed to radiation. The State Commission, which was established by the Soviet Union to investigate the causes of the accident, declared the plant personnel and management to be the chief responsible for the accident. Plant manager Viktor Bryuhanov and chief engineer Nikolai Fomin were sentenced to 10 years each. Deputy Chief Engineer Anatoly Dyatlov, 5 years, Reactor Supervisor Alexander Kovalenko, 3 years, Shift Supervisor Boris Rogojakin and Supervisor Yuri Loshkin were sentenced to 2 years each, for violating safety rules. The Soviet Union spent $18 billion to manage and decontaminate the disaster area. The financial, human and moral costs of the Chernobyl disaster led to the collapse and disintegration of the USSR in 1991. The last functioning reactor of the Chernobyl nuclear power plant was shut down on December 15, 2000. The wreckage of the nuclear disaster reactor was covered with a giant steel shield in 2016 to prevent radioactive leakage. An area of nearly 4,000 square kilometers have been abandoned. The city of Pripyat has turned into a ghost city. Agriculture is prohibited and settlement is not allowed in the region. After the explosion, all the pine trees near the power plant turned red with the effect of high radiation. Today, a firefighter memorial is deployed near the power plant for the heroic and brave firefighters who prevented the disaster from growing in the first moments. We should all be grateful to those who prevented this catastrophe from escalating at the cost of their own lives.